We worship your name. thank you, Jesus. From January to December, the grace of God is our life, protecting us, our family, day and night. Our God, you too much. We bless your name, we glorify your name. Blessed be your name. I want to see this one, my darling. Put your life into God's hand. Everything will be all right. All your heart desire will come to pass. God bless your name, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hey, that boy, Baba.
is here right now. Bless your name, Lord.
I pray in the morning.
Blessed be to your name. You are heavenly Father of miracles. Blessed be your name, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You are going from glory to glory.
Yeah.
I said you are going from glory to glory.
Yeah.
I said you are going from glory to glory.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Daniel chapter 2. Now look at verse 19. There was the secret revealed to Daniel in the night vision. And Daniel blessed the God of heaven. Daniel's answer and said, blessed be the name of God forever and ever, for wisdom and might are his. He changed the times and the season. About 4 months ago, people say it's too hot. But by his power, he changed the time and the season. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
God will change something concerning you for good. Family of the church, whatever has to do with them, God will change it for good this morning. He will remove kids, every wicked kid that said you will not go forward, God will remove them from the throne. And seated up kids, and give wisdom unto the wise, and knowledge unto them that know understanding. 22. He revealed the deep. And secretly he knew what is in the darkness, and the light dwelleth with him. 23. I thank thee and praise thee, O God of my Father, who has given me wisdom and might, and has made me knowing now what the desire of thee. For thou art now, God has now made knowing unto all the king's matter. When you are close to the Most High God, every trap the enemy has set, every evil secret of the witches and witchcraft, God will place them into your
hands. Yeah.
This morning, you are going to drop your Bible, you are going to pray a very violent prayer. The people that the enemy has assigned to die in December, I and my family will not part of them.
Yeah.
Listen to this, listen to this. The Bible said Daniel was not destroyed with the wise men of Babylon. Because of Daniel's prayer, Daniel's life and his friend's life was saved. Maybe because of this one prayer you want to pray, you will save the life of somebody in your family.
Yeah.
Today is the first Sunday in the month of December. Do that the enemy has assigned to die. I am my husband, you know the part of him. We are going to become a living soul. Open your mouth and pray that prayer.
I begin to make incarnation. Some people want to die. They want to use, in family, they want to use other people to replace. But God told me their arrow will recover. You are going to pray. Arrow of sickness. Arrow of death. And you are not your candidate. You are a liar. Return back to your center.
Look at all these years.
There are some battles you see. There are some you don't see at all. Sometimes they lie against you. Sometimes they speak words so that you can fall. Sometimes they do some certain things. But see me and you in the presence of God this morning. Everlasting Father, we have come to appreciate you. The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Covenant giving God. The will of the enemy did not come to pass. Father, we thank you for offering us in your presence this morning. Take glory, take honor, take adoration. We now decree that every death arrow, arrow of sickness, arrow of racism, that you now be someone to say, Happy New Year this year for me. And it's coming back to the same way. God is a God of the living. It's not the God of the dead. He said it's the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. These people, they are still living. We are, Father, in the name that is above all name, we have come into the last stage of the year, which is December month. Father in heaven, whatsoever my heavenly Father has not planted, every tree, even tree, my heavenly Father has not planted the new ones like this. Let it be a fruit of my soul. Let it be a fruit of my soul. Let it be a fruit of my soul. I saw, truly there are shouts and there are enchantments. He said in Numbers 23:23, surely there's no any enchantment against Jacob. There is no any divination against Israel. Anyone they have taken their name to a swing, all their pictures to a swing, read the sheet earlier. Those who think they are the Supreme Master, let the hands be pure. 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 You will not bury anyone in your family. Take honor this morning. Take adoration this morning.
Hallelujah. I don't know what the Lord has said about you since January to date, but I believe as the year is coming to an end, the Lord has settled it. Hallelujah. Amen. Worshiping in this auditorium, I want to know you
from the right side, looking up above. Yes, I know.
Father, Lord King of Glory,
She has come to encounter you this morning, O Lord. Father, Lord King of glory, let it show in her, O Heavenly Father, Lord, that she has come to Zion this morning, O Lord. Father, Lord King of glory, I declare upon her, O Lord, testimonies, O God.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, Lord King of glory, you will use her to your own glory.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, Lord, we thank you. Blessed be your holy Lord.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's listen to the rest of the announcement. Please take notes. All visitors are welcome in Jesus' mighty name. Tuesdays are choir practice by 7 p.m. and Saturday by 4:30 p.m. Wednesdays are Bible study and prayer meeting from 7:30 p.m. and Thursdays are house fellowship from 2 p.m. Praise God. Fridays is our workers meeting from 7:30 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. and Saturdays our children choir practice from 1:30 p.m. promise. Our church bookshop opens immediately after the church service. Contact Sister Blessing and Sister Osarati. For water baptism and marriage counseling, contact Pastor Moses on Onose every Saturday by 2 p.m. If you know you've not been baptized by immersion, please make yourself available. For refreshment during and after the church service, please contact Sister Kate. For prayers and counseling, contact our pastor every Saturday by 2 p.m. Amen.
Amen.
The women prayer meeting is the second and last Monday of every month. As we contact Minister Mojisola Falola, Deaconess Beauty Enabulele, and Minister Kemi Omole. The men's meeting is the second and last Sunday of every month as we contact Elder Richard. The business prayer meeting is the last Saturday of every month as we contact Deaconess Juliet Ogunsin. The Charity and Evangelical Group meet on the first and third Sunday of every month as we contact Sister Samuel. The ushering department, they meet every Saturday by 10 a.m. Contact Pastor Sonny. Praise the Lord. The family of Brother Solomon and Sister Rachel, baby dedication is coming forth on Sunday the 11th of December 2016. Amen.
Amen.
Our church Christmas Carol Night is coming forth on the 23rd and 24th of December 2016. Amen.
Amen.
Our CKVC Ponce de Inca branch annual Thanksgiving is coming forth on the 10th and 11th of December 2016. Please, let's join them to celebrate this glorious occasion. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Let's join them as we celebrate the goodness of God in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
These are the handbills. Please, we are going to share the handbills. You try as much as you can to invite at least. You can invite more than 10, but at least invite one person. We are going to join them to celebrate this glorious occasion. I don't know if the ushers can help us with this one. Hallelujah. There are few, please. Try and invite someone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Please take note that on Monday the 5th of December 2016, which is tomorrow, is our church morning power encounter from 10 a.m. to 12 noon. And every first Sunday is our Thanksgiving and Love Feast. Every first Monday is our morning power encounter. Every first Wednesday is our hour of divine intervention. And every first Friday is our general all-night vigil. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. There will be a traditional marriage between the family of Faith, William Ekoa, and Osayende Edionwe come Sunday the 22nd of January 2017, venue Ogbeson Primary School Road, Igbovahi. Please, if you'll be traveling to Nigeria, please try as much as possible to join this couple to celebrate this great day. Hallelujah. If you want the address, you can meet me or Pastor Dave, or the celebrant herself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Come January as well, the families of Edugie
Edugan. Okay, that ceremony on the 21st of January. The venue is Ubekun Primary School, Upper Sakmon Barrow, Benin City. Please, if you want the address, you can meet me, Pastor Dave, or the celebrants as well. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. After the word, we'll be having a special number from Brother Edokba Clarence Akere. As well, we'll be having the birthday celebration of Brother Michael, Brother Anoluwa, and Sister Michela. So also, we'll be having the thanksgiving of Brother Daniel Onorode Francis. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Can we please stand up as we take the congregation and him? Please don't forget the ushers. They are going to take action as from next week Sunday. If the prayer is going on, stand still. Don't move around. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
25. Holy, holy, holy.
woman needs to be. Thank you because you are important to the present God. We commit your children, that their children will cover with the blood of Jesus. Jehovah Esh should take adoration in their life. Father, continue to do great things in their life, Father. We that you don't have to bring the time, Father. Jehovah Esh that next time, Father, provide for us to bring in our mighty name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we thank you, Almighty Father, for the offering we are going to give. Father, we commit our hands. Father, King, fill our hands with your glory in our mighty name.
Amen.
Every basket that the enemy has put in our life, Father, King of glory, as you use the blood of Jesus to cover those baskets in our mighty name.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Amen. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Offering.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
We give glory to the Lord. Amen. We give glory to the Lord. Amen.
Oh,
wonderful. The first Sunday of the month of December. Praise the Lord. Our Bible reading this morning is taken from the book of Luke. Luke chapter 12. Verse 15. Are we there?
Yes, ma'am.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I read. Verse 15. And he said unto them, take heed and beware of covetousness. For a man's life consists not in the abundance of the things which he possesses. 16. And he spake a parable unto them, saying, the ground of a certain rich man brought forth plentifully. 17. And he thought between himself, saying, what shall I do? Because I have no room here to bestow my fruits. And he said, this will I do. I will put down my barns. We understand what barns mean.
Yes.
The thing will put me out in the village.
Yes.
We have plenty. Praise the Lord. And build greater. And there will I bestow all my fruits and my goods. 19, verse 19. And I will say to my soul, so thou hast much goods. Let up for many years. Take thy ease, eat, drink, and be merry. 20. For God said unto him, thou fool, this night thy soul shall be required of thee. Then whose shall those things be which thou hast provided? I pray that will not be our portion in Jesus' name. And will not be greedy in Jesus' name.
Amen.
21. So he that laid up treasure for himself and not rich towards God. 22. And he said unto his disciples, therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what ye shall eat, neither for the body, what ye shall put on. 23. The life is more than meat, and the body is more than raiment. Do you know we are privileged to believe in Jesus?
Yes.
Many people worry over everything. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As a believer, we put our trust in God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Verse 24. Consider the revenue, for they neither sow nor reap, which neither have storehouse or barn, and God feedeth them. How much more are ye better than fowls? 25. And which of you, with taking thought, can add to his stature one cubit? 26. If ye then be not able to do that thing which is least, why take ye thought for the rest? 27. Say, consider the lily, how they grow. They turn not, they spleen not. Yet I say unto you, that Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Verse 28. So if then God do close the grass, which is today in the field, and tomorrow is cast into the oven, how much more will he not clothe you, O ye of little faith? May the Lord bless his word in our heart in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And I increase our faith even today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We worship you, God, and pray your blessing. We the name of the Lord, from Jesus' mighty name, I pray.
Waymaker, oh yeah, in my life you are the Prince of Peace.
on the children choir. Let's give Jesus a round of applause. And on behalf of that wonderful leader from the teenager, let's give Jesus a round of applause. And on behalf of Shalom Special Number, let's give Jesus a round of applause. And that you are here, you are not in the hospital, you are in the sanctuary, you are not in the mortuary, that you are in the presence of God this morning. I want you to give Jesus a round of applause. His presence, we appreciate him so much. Please, I want you to listen to this. We have entered in the month of December, and today is the first Sunday in the month of December. Please, tomorrow is our morning power encounter. What do I call it? It's a time of prayer. We'll be praying from 10 o'clock in the morning to 12 o'clock in the middle of the day. Especially women, after you might have dropped children in the school, maybe by 9 o'clock you should find your way by 10, you should be in the church. We shall be praying from 10 o'clock to 12 tomorrow, and that tomorrow we'll be fasting. If you know you are not pregnant, you are not medically fit, please don't fast. But if you know you are okay, nothing is wrong with you, please, while you are coming that morning, don't eat anything. We'll be fasting till 1 o'clock. Until after the prayer, before we can eat something. Amen.
Amen.
And this coming Wednesday is a special Wednesday that will be fasting. This Wednesday will be fasting from 6 to 3 p.m. And by 7 p.m., all of us will be here in the evening time for a special prayer. Hallelujah. And this Wednesday, we will read Revelation chapter 1, verse 1 to 18. Tomorrow, you don't need to take any reading, just come to the church direct. But Wednesday, Revelation chapter 1, verse 1 to 18. I will be fasting from 6 to 3. Amen. Amen. Maybe this fasting might be for you. You may not know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Or give yourself into prayer and fasting. Amen.
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 Some of you can see what prayer is doing now. All the missed call now, several call, and it's a certain message. I believe you know, I will be in the church now. Because my sister left us, she was in Dubai. She arrived in Nigeria yesterday night, and she sent her love, according to the message she sent out to the whole church, especially to all the women, that she loves you, that thank you for all your care and everything you have done, that the Lord will continue to bless all of you.
Amen.
Bless your children,
amen,
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We are going to stand up and pray. And before we pray this prayer, I want you to turn your Bible to Isaiah chapter 60. It's one prayer we are going to pray. It's a very vital prayer. Isaiah chapter 60, as we stand up to our feet, every one of us. Stand up to our feet. Isaiah chapter 60, we open to verse 15. Isaiah 60, verse 15. That is where we are going to use to pray right now. I'm going to read it for you. I believe we are all there now. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 15. He said, whereas thou hast been forsaken and hated, so that no man went through you, I will make you an eternal excellence.
Amen.
The joy of many generations.
Amen.
You are going to pray, Lord, as the word is coming. Make me an eternal excellence. A joy of many generations. Enemy will not steal your word from me today.
Amen.
Those who distract people when the word is going on, they will not distract my attention.
Amen.
Father, visit me this hour.
Amen.
Make me a joy of many generations. An eternal excellency. Open your mouth and pray that prayer. Turn me to be a joy of many generations and eternal excellency. As your word is coming, enemy will not collect it from my hand. Children of the wicked will not distract me. Enemy will not distract my attention. I will soak into the word of God, and the word will bring your glory upon my life and my family.
For in Jesus' wonderful name we have prayed.
Amen.
Every territorial spirit, we burn them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every territorial power, we burn them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every environmental disturbance, we nullify them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We lose every soul here to the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We ask in the name of Jesus, everything that we distract, what distract people from soaking into the word of miracle. Father, we destroy those things right now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We ask, all of us, we go through your word, let your glory begin to descend another dimension. Father, we appreciate you. Yes, you are the Lord.
Oh, son. Yes, you are.
Testimony. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Every miracle in the Bible begins with problem and trouble. From Genesis to Revelation, every miracle you ever see in the Bible or breakthrough begins with problem and trouble. That is why the Bible says trial to testimony. Every of your trial today is a turn for a testimony.
Yeah.
I'm not hearing your loud amen.
Yeah.
I'm not hearing your loud amen.
Yeah.
Every miracle that ever happened in this Bible begins with problems and trouble. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
As long as you are born of woman, you will encounter challenges in life. But God, through Jesus, has given me a new victory. And that victory will be forever and ever.
Yeah.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yeah.
For example, we begin quickly from the book of John chapter 2, verse 1 to 11. The Bible said their wine finished. Jesus was invited into a marriage ceremony and there was no wine. Could you imagine people were celebrating and they are in the middle of celebrating and everything was going on, jam-packed, drum was going, music was going, and there's no wine to drink. And no even any drink. But because Jesus was invited into their wedding, then there must be a miracle. That's a miracle marriage. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the mother of Jesus went to come and he said, their wine is finished. And Jesus said, it's not yet my time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nevertheless, let us help them. The Bible said the first miracle that Jesus did in the Cana of Galilee, when he manifested forth his glory and the people believed him, was to turn water into wine. Hallelujah.
Amen.
John chapter 2, verse 11. This beginning of the miracle that Jesus did in the Cana of Galilee, when he manifested forth his glory and the people believed in him, there was a trouble, but trouble turned to a triumph.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In Luke chapter 5, verse 1 to 8. The Bible said there are four fishermen, including their leader called Peter, who have toiled all night. They were professional fishermen. That is their labor. That is where they eat. That is where they don't catch fish, they don't sell, they don't get money to feed themselves and feed their family. That is where their source comes from. But perhaps enemy has blocked their source, that they will not catch fish. The best time to catch fish is in the middle of the night. Hallelujah. Not in the daytime. Middle of the night is the best time to cast multitude of fish. But the Bible said they toil all night. To toil all night is a trouble. And no one, four of them, will catch one fish. Then Jesus begged them that he wants to use their boat. And they give their boat to Jesus. Please follow this. They were the service of God. We read in the Bible this morning, a man said, I have built house for myself, I have food now, I can eat many days. That same day that man was speaking, he could not give glory to God. He was boasting of the property he had. He was boasting of so many things he had. He was hopeful of the money he had and the food he has at home. Then God said, because you have said it from your mouth and it comes from your heart, I am collecting my own heart that I gave to you. And God ended up his life that night. He passed away. Think of it for one moment. Many of your great friends have built a house. They even have big gym, but they have passed away. But you are alive.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Yes. So when Peter allowed his boat to be used, then Jesus told the people and he said, Peter, launch into the deep. Peter said it is impossible because it's a daytime. In the night we have tried to cast fish. We could not cast nothing. In the daytime, nevertheless, at what you are saying, I will do what you say. And as he launched the net, they were begging people to come and help them to pack blessing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your blessing is at your doorstep.
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 Amen.
From trial to testimony.
Yes.
Think of Joseph. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Joseph was helping his own brother by taking food to them. When he got to the place he used to meet them, they were no more there. A stranger appeared to him. In a Bible study, we were told that it might be angels. This man asked him, what are you looking for? He said, I am looking for my brethren. He said, I heard them say, we are going to Lotham. And that is the place he found them. Now, Joseph find himself in trouble by telling his brethren his own dream. His truth. Praise the Lord, somebody. I remember many years ago when I said, God told me that I should build him a 7,000 on the throne in Lagos. Oh, I entered into a very big trouble. Very big one that I cannot even explain now. But anyone who got to that place today will glorify God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because those people who bring the trouble, they thought they are the one that is my source.
Mm.
They don't know where the source is coming from. In fact, they tried to do it, they tried to find out how many things they could not know. Hallelujah. You see, Joseph telling his brethren his dream. He entered trouble. From trouble to triumph, from trial to a testimony. Somebody, you are here. Your testimony has finally come.
Yeah.
Your testimony has finally come.
Yeah.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Now, listen to me very well. Oh, that man's my baby. Called Joseph. All what we read in the Bible is not all what happened. If the Bible have to begin to write all what happened to Joseph, I think perhaps you will be crying for Joseph now. That man suffered that he could not wear even cloth. He was just ordinary like that, a young mature man at the age of 17 or so. Okay, somebody rescued him as a slave. Slave. When we say slave, slave used to have numbers. They used to number them. The slave that Joseph represents has no number. Joseph has no number. So if he lost forever and ever. He was a type of like dog. Even dog is better. One of my neighbors, they bring me for him. His hand was shaking. Where I live, he's a white man. A dog was living fine. He clothed his dog with cloth. A dog has his own. Eat best food. If the dog says, I don't want to eat, he begins to bend the dog and buy another food. When they bring me for him, he was shaking like this. I said, ah, Baba, look at your dog. He don't know me. Your dog doesn't know now what is happening in your life. He enter home. If you want to go out, he said, I want to smoke. He smoke. You go with this room, come and eat and sleep like a baby. I said, this is how God created we human beings from the origin. But sin that we committed make us to begin to labor today. And be gone, and you want to be before God. That is it. Brethren, let me just tell you one gospel truth. If you are not at rest now, and you say you are serving God, you are not serving God. You are in a very big problem, and you need to come out of that problem. Hallelujah.
Amen.
During the week, I was in KRCC in London. In KRCC in London, this man collected land, the new church. Oh, very big. You can drive inside, you can walk around. Where to buy a flat there? You know how much they sell a flat there? They even to rent a house. Then somebody collected land like that and built. It's not normal. God might have stepped in. Somebody, you are here. God is stepping into your case this morning.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm not hearing your daddy.
Yeah.
God might have stepped in. When God stepped into your case, your enemy will say, never die. They will be taking something bad to happen to you. He said, but he that keepeth Israel never sleep. Never slumber. Day and night, my God will keep you.
Yeah.
This God will not leave you alone.
Yeah.
Now somebody now puts Joseph as a slave inside the house. And the wife of that person lied against him. You know we are talking about lie. Do you know lie is better than talking? When you carry one, you sue somebody, it's better than you lie against somebody.
Yes,
oh, you don't know that?
Yes, sir.
There's a man who just came out from prison, a white man. They said he was mad and killed somebody, and he was in prison for 21 years.
Yes.
So he's already old. Mm. Now they now find that he was not the one.
Yes.
What is going to bring the restoration? Yes. Is it money?
No.
Is it what are they going to do to bring the restoration? Yes. Somebody who stayed 21 years in jail, and it's not the one, he's innocent. Why? Because somebody lied. To kill somebody instantly is better. Why? Because Pastor, what is with you? Bear me with you. Because you are a married counselor.
Yes, sir.
Because it's a married counselor.
Yeah,
okay. You will not agree. But when your wife agrees, you do one and you say it is true. You know that man, you need to kill him. Let us plan how to destroy him. No, 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 no. But remember, God is listening to two of you. The conversation. How you are planning it. Everything you are planning, God is listening. And God sent his stranger to block it.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, Joseph, your master said, what my wife told me, is it true? Joseph said, will your wife lie to you again? Ah, so it's true. Oh, yeah, dear. Now, Joseph was trying to protect the woman so that there will be no divorce. The man showed trust Joseph and asked, give me everything to Joseph. If Joseph would have said, your wife is lying, ah, that woman is gone. It will bring divorce. But God said, whatsoever God has joined together, let no man put out of that. Joseph might have remembered that. He said, will your wife lie? Then they put Joseph in trouble, in prison. But favor of God looking at him. Favor of God will locate somebody here too.
Yeah.
I said, favor of God will locate somebody here too. Was crying for Joseph, I need you. Palace was groaning for Joseph, it's you we are waiting for. Then, came from prison, he landed in the palace. Can you see from trial to what?
Testimony.
You don't know the team again. From trial, that is where somebody is going to right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Let somebody read it for us quickly as time is running up. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1.
Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for.
Okay.
The evidence of things not seen.
Faith is the substance of things hoped for. The evidence of things not seen. Please listen to this today's message. Being the first Sunday in the month of December. Now, when you go down to that Bible, it said, for by it the elder obtained what? Good report. Now, my question is that did Joseph know that God will talk to him in the bush when he ran for his life? There is a trouble. Joseph, take off. Okay, God forbid, but they say police is looking for somebody now. That because Joseph and Moses, sorry, Moses killed somebody. And when they hear about it, they said it's going to do for him. He became so fugitive. They put him, he's slaughtered everywhere. Wanted for maybe Tracy and Fenodio. I don't know the name they used about them. Those who came, the murderer. But he was helping his own brethren, his own people. Because the Bible said he preferred to suffer affliction with God's people than to enjoy pleasure for a season. Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, that's not trouble, it's a trouble. He run for his life. I believe, my brethren, that Moses never dreamed he will ever return back to Egypt. Never! Because he has escaped, he has run away. Though they were looking for him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But when he returned back, no one could stand him, including their kings. Why? He was empowered. But we are not going to that now. Moses never knew he will meet, or he has heard about God. He has heard about Almighty God, that there is God, the God of Abraham, but he never knew God can talk to him face to face inside forest. When Moses fled for his life, he got to the forest and bush began to cast fire. Nobody liked it. And somebody speak from the fire that the bush was burning, but the bush could not consume. And somebody was speaking from the fire. I am that I am. Remove your soul from where you are standing. Is holy. Ah! He ran away and threw the stick in his hand. From that stick, he said, what is in your hand? He said, rod. He said, throw it on the floor. He turned to a snake. He said, that the snake we used to torment them as a sign to them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is a man they have planned his downfall. This is a man they have gathered together how they might have killed him if they catch him. But God turned him to another man. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, you know the rest of the story. He returned back to Egypt. He became a demigod. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What he said to the king, if they don't do it, they will be dead. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now that is how Moses escaped temptation. Somebody who escaped temptation.
Amen.
Somebody who escaped temptation.
Amen.
He said, when you look at Hebrews 11:24, he said, for he endured as seeing him who is invisible. He was looking at invisible God. God that we cannot see, but is looking at me and you. He said, by faith, they crossed the Red Sea just like they are walking on a dry ground. When the enemy were trying to do what they do, they were drowned. There are some things you cannot do. When the enemy are trying to do what you are doing, because they don't know God has empowered you, something happened to them. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17. From trial to testimony. Thank you, Jesus. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17. Let's look at this.
2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17.
Uh-huh.
For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding an eternal weight of glory.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Yes.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Yes.
Our light affliction. What did they call it?
Our light affliction.
That means anything you are going through is not heavy. They call it light. It's too small. The word light there means a small thing in the presence of God. God, who take him only 7 days to create the heaven and earth and the host of it, will it take him 7 months to solve your problem? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do you believe it will not take him? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Now, I want to show you something here. Now, the same Bible was saying something. He said, don't put your eyes on the temporary things you can see. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The same Corinthians. He said, why we look at the thing? Well, I think you know it.
Yes, sir.
Why we look at the thing? Not seen. And the thing that was seen. For the thing that was seen by what? God bless you, you know it. The thing you can see is temporal. He said, but the thing we cannot see is what?
Eternal.
Now, they bring cut paper. You see cut paper today is temporal things because you can see it. But you see, the thing you cannot see, the glory and the blessing, that is in front, your eyes do not see them, you only see cut paper, which today will be wiped away, will be become a forgotten issue. The thing which we have seen were temporal. Maybe Salem, you are in the Salem this hour, this morning, and you are sitting here, and people don't know what you are going through. Those things, the Bible says, they are temporary. They are what?
Temporary.
Why we look at the thing that we have seen that we are temporal? The thing we cannot see, they were eternal, permanent glory. Are you following me now? Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
The thing that you can see, some certain challenges, some certain problem that you are inside right now, the Bible called them, God called them temporary things. I have experienced so many things in my little journey with God. And I have seen some people who have experienced so many things in their little journey. Today, those things are forgotten. One of my sons in the law in this church was looking for paper. Document. Seeing is believing. No, that can be wrong. That can be what? There's something you don't see that are powerful. Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
I see God taking you from glory to glory.
Amen.
I see God taking you from glory to glory.
Yes.
From a stumble to a miracle.
Yes.
Any celebrity that stands before you this morning will turn to a blessing in your hand.
Yes.
Will turn to a great blessing in your hand in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
In that 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14, it says, but the natural man receives not the thing of the Spirit. For their foolishness unto him, neither can they know it, because they are spiritually discerned. Ordinary human being will not understand the thing of the Spirit, from trial to a testimony. Every human being will face trial. Every human being will face challenges. Challenges is what we are about to face. But there is one word, and that word is 1 John 5:4. Whosoever is born of God, overcome the world. And this is the victory that overcome the world. Even our faith. If you are faithless, I'm sorry. You must be very faithful. Let them be fighting themselves. Don't you want to prove that they will be fighting themselves? Don't you want to be that they will be fighting themselves? Just not care of the one in Barcelona, not the one in Madrid, not the one in London, the one in Mallorca, the one in Boston. And I climbed the Google and said, I need €5 just to eat. I said, but how I may get €1,000 from one person? He said, ah, I said, yes. You are the one suffering, you need prayer. He looked for a way to order, they came to me the second day for prayer here. He need prayer. I can tell you, he need prayer. Such person need healthy prayer. If I don't pastor in church in Europe, if I should land in Nigeria, I think 5 years they will not see me this my life. 5 years. Hallelujah.
Amen.
By the time you see me, you say, ah, no.
What if I want to go?
Yeah.
those that were born in the month of December. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Before we sing happy birthday for them, hallelujah. Some of us, they are not here yesterday. She's Alicia celebrated our own birthday yesterday here. And she cut cake. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So we have Anno here. Like father, like son. Praise the Lord. Amen. We have Michael here. We have Michelle here. Michelle, hallelujah.
Amen.
I want us to stretch a hand towards them and pray for them. That God will increase them, God will bless them, that they will lead to celebrate on earth. They have remembered today. Let's pray for them. Pray for them, pray for the children. Oh, Nikashika Liba Taka Shake Libro Jigaria. Lekitukushika Liba Naka Shakalia. Laka Tukushika Libo Robo Shekelia. We appreciate you all for who you are. For in Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Bless them abundantly.
Amen.
And that we say teach us to numbers our lips that we may apply our heart unto wisdom. Lord, give them wisdom and understanding.
Amen.
They will grow in wisdom.
Amen.
They will grow in power.
Amen.
They will grow in anointing.
Amen.
Anointing that break every yoke.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you because you are with them. I cover them with the blood of Jesus. And I seal them with the power of heaven.
Amen.
For in Jesus' wonderful name we have prayed.
Amen.
If you know you are born in the month of December, just raise up your hand. You know anywhere you can be. Now we pray for you. Just find your way towards here a little bit. A little bit. You are born in the month of December. Please find your way a little bit here. December month. Rekashika. No December. December month. Rekashika. Liboromo. Shekelea. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we pray for all those that are born in the month of December. Bless them. Increase them. But this time next year, you will be coming with a treaty God has done for you. That is from and those any of you shall prosper. The glory of God shall be seen upon your life, upon your destiny. I cover all of you with the blood of Jesus. For Jesus' wonderful name we have prayed.
Amen.
Now, let us sing happy birthday for all of you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
before we go ahead. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
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 Oh, well, these people are very wonderful. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
The Lord.
They don't want to give you a microphone. Why?
Praise the Lord. For his faithfulness in my life and in my family. The Lord has been so faithful. When I said faithful, he abides. The Lord is so faithful. When I say faithful, I mean the Lord is so faithful. I'm here to return all of glory, all honor. You did it the way I did not even expect. You have performed all for me. Even know what I need next for God. Father, thank you. And I want to use the opportunity to say, Daddy, thank you for you being my backbone. Me standing with him, I don't shake. I sleep like nothing they happen. Daddy, thank you so much. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Mighty, so great. I don't know how to thank you. I just have a testimony. Just give you glory and give you thanks.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's pray for him. Hallelujah. Pray for him that God will cause joy in the heart of this young man.
and the mother, the choice of the permanent. Let's pray for them, let's pray for them. Pray for them. Oh, look at Shika, look at Shika. You brought him closer to his home. Father, what you say came to pass. Lord, we appreciate you. Thank you, Jesus. For in Jesus' wonderful name we have prayed.
Yeah.
I'm asking, Father, we commit your son Daniel, we commit her mom into your hand. It's you that promised you never get it closer. Came to pass. Father, Lord God, he came today to return glory to you. Father, whatever this young man desire, let it come into you.
Yeah.
Pray for them. Pray for them. Pray for them.